Hello, Dr. Carlo Oger here, emergency physician. Atrial fibrillation is the most common type of serious arrhythmia. It involves a very fast and very irregular contraction of the atria. In atrial fibrillation, the heart's electrical signals don't begin in the SA node. Instead, they begin in another part of the atria or in nearby pulmonary veins. The signals don't travel normally. They may spread throughout the atria in a rapid, disorganized way. This causes the walls of the atria to quiver very fast and fibrillate, instead of beating normally or contracting normally. As a result, the atrias aren't able to pump the blood into the ventricles the way they should. In atrial fibrillation, the electrical signals can travel through the atria at a rate of more than 300 beats per minute. Some of these abnormal signals can travel to the ventricles, causing them to beat too fast and with an irregular rhythm. AF, atrial fibrillation, usually isn't life-threatening, but it can be dangerous if it causes the ventricles to beat very fast. Atrial fibrillation has two major complications, stroke and heart failure. In atrial fibrillation, blood can pool in the atria, causing blood clots to form. If a clot breaks off and travels into the brain, it can cause a stroke. Blood thinning medicines that reduce the risk of stroke are an important part of treatment for people who have atrial fibrillation. Heart failure occurs if the heart can't pump enough blood to meet the body's need. Atrial fibrillation can lead to heart failure because the ventricles aren't, although beating very fast, cannot completely fill with blood and are inefficient. They don't take enough blood and they're not able to pump all the blood they need for proper bodily function. Damage to the heart's electrical system causes atrial fibrillation. The damage most often is the result of other conditions that affect the health of the heart, such as high blood pressure, coronary heart disease, and rheumatic heart disease. Inflammation also is thought to play a role in the development of atrial fibrillation. Other conditions also can lead to AF, including an overactive thyroid gland, too much thyroid hormones being produced, and heavy alcohol use. The risk of AF increases with age. Sometimes AF and other supraventricular arrhythmias can occur for no obvious reason. Atrial flutter is very similar to AF. However, the heart's electrical signals spread through the atria in a fast and regular, instead of irregular, rhythm. Atrial flutter is much less common than AF, but it has similar symptoms and complications. A lot of times, it's treated the same way.